I'm using this recording to narrate the damages on Roger Lacey's garage, and it was destroyed by Sue Rabbi's tree across the road. And it's combined with some video, so that should be more self-explanatory. The first ones on the scene was David Foster, and then Kurt called up Roger and let him know that a tree had fallen, and then he called me up, and that's how I got involved. But the fire department was notified so they can clear the road, because the oak tree, the dead oak tree actually, was blocking through traffic. So here you see the fire department as I advise them to park on my property and carry in the chainsaws to proceed to clear the road. We have an excellent fire department. They're up here within 5 minutes if you call for an emergency. And they were. And they did their job as they usually do, as you can see in this video.
But yeah, I thought it was... My God, we got the pot.
So the fire department did arrive, and they brought up an entire crew, and with their large 4-foot bar to cut this giant tree on the hillside. Definitely Sue Rabbi needs to be more responsible as a neighbor to prune the damaged trees to prevent this. But she won't spend any money whatsoever and should be held accountable or liable for any damages, or even human lives can be lost, crushed under one of these giant limbs that had fallen down. And this isn't the first tree. Other trees have fallen in the past, and she hasn't done a darn thing to prevent it.
Pretty big rounds right there.
Yeah, they are. I have a...
CDF were successful in cutting them and lowering them onto the road to make them safe. It was a slow, methodical process to cut the rounds and lower them to the road. They were quite heavy. The CDF Fire Department were only obligated to cut and move the oak tree rounds to the side of the road and some in front of Rogers. That's all they had to do. But we're still fortunate to have that crew be able to do that. It is something that is a service for emergencies only. So we're thankful for that. And it's still out there though. Sue hasn't done anything.
Big swing shot.
Boy, you're gonna get a hernia.
Roll that one down there.
What's that?
Is this a specialty over here? What's going on?
Yeah.
Huh?
I was gonna take a little extra work. I was afraid if I left it long, I was gonna swing down and hit the hydrant, so yeah. That wouldn't have been good. Not the rock blocks would stop it. But.
Well, this is being worked on.
It should have been worked on and finished 6 months ago.
It sank.
It never would have gone down there. So this might encourage him to finish it off.
I was able to speak to the captain of this crew and was asking him, what can we do to get the neighbors to cooperate and make our back roads safer? Again, as you've seen in the video, and it'll continue on, they had to carefully remove these huge rounds to the side of the road. One of them, unfortunately, when they were rolling it off the hill, went down the ravine and butted up against the home. It was quite large. It didn't damage the cabin, but then they had to do some special cutting so that they wouldn't cut through the log to make it lighter so they can roll it out and cut through the cabin at the same time. It was nice to see how skillful they are, how careful. It's just an unfortunate thing that the log had rolled and passed the barrier on the other side of the road. But again, they continued on removing the debris and making everything safe for the neighbors, especially Kurt's home. He's very vulnerable for any trees that might fall from Sue Rabbi's property, or even some that are on the association property. It would crush that cabin and kill Claire and Kurt instantly if that wasn't addressed.
We moved in and inherited the cabin from my neighbors in 1956. And I've been brought up here in 1950 to rake leaves for my neighbors. Now they're my leaves and I'm still raking them up.
Oh, where did you live back then?
On 98th Avenue and East 14th Street, East Oakland, when it was safe to walk the streets.
Yeah.
Well, I wouldn't even drive my car down East 14th Street now.
Yeah, that's a shame.
Yeah, it is. But I live here for years, you know, and
yeah,
it's just so peaceful. I think I might splice some of this up and make a, what they call an educational of. This is how TDF does it.
Yeah, you're going old school.
Yeah, of course, I can say. I know the history.
The crew is in the final stages of removing what is in the ravine, and then all they were left to do was to gather their equipment and be ready to move on to the next project. And CDF are only within 5 minutes of the cabin.
Copy that, copy that.
Split, it just needs the breaker.
Well, needless to say, it's kudos to the CDF Fire Department that are located just outside of Sunol Main Street on Foothill Road. They're a great crew, very conscientious of how they work around the neighbor's area. They clean up after themselves. And are very resourceful. With this fire danger that we're having and being within 4 years of a drought, they come up and monitor. They send inspectors to come and look at the yard. They don't cite anyone. All they're trying to do is make the neighbors aware that they should be conscious of clearing debris around their yard, clear out the brush, and prune the trees. And more so, to clear out any hazardous trees that are either dead, or especially the bay trees that are nothing but a flamethrower or a torch, because they're full of oil that will catch fire and burn a long time. All trees burn, but the bay trees and the small brush below them, the witch's broom, is very flammable and could be started very easily. So again, Anytime I can assist the CDF, explain where the situation is, if it's in my area, and I allow them to park on my property. It's just a matter of courtesy and a thankfulness.
It ain't no surprise, sparks started flying like the 4th of July. She gets me so